So the second of the bronze medals here in the men's heavyweight division, Olympic Taekwondo from London 2012. And as long as we see two athletes, we will be okay. The first of the bronze medals going by withdrawal to Russia. But here, in blue, is Liu Xiaobo of China. And there in red is Bahri Tanrikulu from Turkey. Still no official explanation, by the way, as to what occurred in that last bronze medal bout. The bronze medal bout that wasn't, with Keita from Mali withdrawal. And the information we've received to date, it appears it was an injury he talked about after losing his semi. I gave everything I could, but I had a big injury and it made it difficult to fight. I worked hard, gave everything. I will see for the bronze medal. Well, it appears that injury was too great, and that's why we didn't see Keita from Mali, although really excited at the prospect. We did see Despons from Cuba, and he took the bronze medal. Now, we'll settle down for this one. Tanrikulu from Turkey, 32 years of age. But his opponent is not a young man either. Liu Xiaobo, 28 years of age, representing China. Really interesting to see, intriguing to see how this one plays out with these two combatants who know each other's games and certainly know their own. This for bronze in the men's heavyweight. And immediately, it's Liu Xiaobo of China in blue. He wants to make the most of his height advantage, but he's opened himself up to Tanrikulu. Takes the first point with a strike to the body. And again, a three-time world champion, silver medalist in Athens. The man from Turkey now with the fist to the body, but just can't score. Has gone up from the welterweight to the heavyweight division for London after a silver medal losing to legendary Lopez from the USA in Athens, and then in fact being beaten by Stephen Lopez again in Beijing in the first round. So he's gone up a level, perhaps to escape Stephen Lopez, who didn't finish in the medals here in London in the welterweight. Can Bahri Tanrikulu? He has that 2-point lead. Stands at 6 foot or 183 centimetres. He's not short. The difference here is that his opponent, who was able to go even higher with the leg and make contact to the head, he stands at 201 centimetres or 6 foot seven, using that advantage there. Liu from China now with the 1 point lead, leading 3 points to two. 3 points for a kick to the head. That's what scored for Liu. Now to the body he goes. Flurry of activity. Nothing registering. 1 point the difference at the end of the first round. China leads Turkey for bronze. Well, as we thought, intriguing to see the way these two go about it. So powerful, so fast. And in the case of Liu Xiaobo there, so precise with that move upstairs. There's the first point to Turkey, to the trunk. It was a good one. And there's the upstairs movement with the front leg. Great reach. Really threw Tanrikulu, didn't it? A quarter finalist in the 2008 Beijing Olympics in the heavyweight is Liu Xiaobo. He likes to play snooker. It helps him calm down and makes his mind clear. So who knows, he might have been knocking the balls around while waiting for this opportunity to go for bronze. He certainly wants to knock his opponent around with a one-point lead as we begin the second round. Trying to go to the body. Lu, no score. Tanrikulu now sitting back, waiting for his opponent to attack. In tight, no holding. Referee gets involved, no warnings. Oh, good spinning move to the body. Not able to get through to the fences. Can score with a punch in Taekwondo, but predominantly those arms are used as defensive levers, and that hurt. Underneath the arm guard there, as Lu again tries to go high now, going to ground. Tanrikulu, no penalty awarded. Margin, as it was at the first break, 3-2. The double kick there from Lu Xiaobo, not scoring. Bahri Tanrikulu of Turkey in red. Younger sister competes at international level in Taekwondo. I'm sure she's got some advice for her brother, trailing by 1 point. Might simply be just score. Get in there and score. It's not as simple as that. It's a complex sport. It's a spectacular sport. And we're seeing it to great effect here in London. Trading blows below the waist. In a blocking motion, no scoring. Below the waist. And open then, wearing the hit and going down, but not giving away the point. It's Tanrikulu of Turkey, so it is still Lu Xiaobo of China who has the 1 point advantage. Through the ripper charge to have this opportunity to fight for bronze was Lu. Tanrikulu, he beat the defending gold medalist, the number one seed Cha of Korea in the quarterfinal. So his form outstanding. He lost to Obama in the semi. And he was able to sit and wait and watch Lu Xiaobo come through the ripper charge. He knows full well what that extra reach is worth. Also very much the heavier of the two. In the heavyweight, it's 80 plus. No maximum. Lu Xiaobo weighing in around 100 kilograms. Tankrikov some 85 to 90. So as you can see, the dexterity these athletes have to display, it's not all about height and weight. Or even power to weight ratio. Speed is just so important, and flexibility. Going up high, unable to score though. Turkey still trailing. Scores are tied at the end of the third 2 minute round. We're off to sudden point in a 1 minute fourth round. And that's what Tanrikulu would be starting to think about. He needs to get one back. Does he go into the body with the fist? The open foot to the body worth one. And in doing that, does he leave himself open for high contact? A kick to the head now worth three, or a spinning kick to the head worth four from Lu, and it would be all over, you would think. Just over a minute remaining. That was strong, but good defense prevented the score. As Lu went in hard to the body, Tanrikulu. And what's happened here? No, just a problem with the glove. Sensors on the feet. And on the gloves, register contact in an automated or electronic protector scoring system. There's also a video appeal system in place that we might see in a contest this tight. Still nothing. If Tanrikulu can't score but thinks he has, now's the time to use it. Great attacking moves there from Lu Xiaobo. Sends his man to the ground. Can't add to the score, but he might not need to. Leads 3 points to two. The bronze medal here for the taking for China. Less than 30 seconds now. Really working the body hard. Tanrikulu, though, can't get through. Oh, that was strong from Lu. He's not sitting back. He's still going at it. Seconds remaining. He has the bronze in his keeping right now. Here comes the last second flurry. Up high, Tanrikulu, but he went to ground. Clock stops, 2 seconds remaining. Unable to get through. He's got one more move, and there it is. And now the siren has sounded on this bout, but I thought we might have had a video review call. Yes, we have. So we have to wait now. The video review call has come from the Turkish coach. Now, it might just be a fishing expedition in the hope that there's something there. The mat judge has called in early, I think, to decide whether the buzzer had sounded before the review was thrown in. We'll wait and see. But right now, on the score sheet, Lu leads 3 points to two and will, in fact, have won the bronze medal. No, we will be hearing the review. So the Turkish coach talks to the referee. He talks to the review jury, and we can listen in. Okay. So in amongst all of that, Lu was on the mat, and if he did that deliberately, if he fell deliberately to avoid a scoring opportunity for Tanrikulu, then he receives a half-point Kungo. Two half-point Kungos together add to a one-point penalty. And if that's the case, the point goes to Turkey and it's 3-3. How did he go down? Did Lu Xiaobo of China go to the ground simply as a stalling tactic? Well, he didn't. So the review, the referee saying there should be 2 seconds on the clock. So they'd have to wind back the clock 2 seconds. Does that mean, discussing that, well, either way, does that mean the review has been dismissed? It can be hard to understand. It really can. I'm not 100% sure on the reasoning for, wow, look at the athleticism there of these two. He went so high to avoid the contact. He didn't actually go to ground, Lu Xiaobo. But that he you don't have to go to ground. You can be penalised for stalling. And maybe he I suppose the Turkish coach is suggesting that Xiaobo actually pushed with the hands, pushed Tanrikulu with the hands and sent him to the ground, which, again, could be that penalty point. So it's a tough one for the review jury. Would he have played that call if it was in the first round, or because there was only seconds remaining? Is this more a hit in hope than anything? It appears as if the appeal has been dismissed, and that means the bronze medal falls as well. It falls to Lu Xiaobo of China. It took an extra couple of minutes, but the elation is still the same for the 28-year-old Lu Xiaobo. His second Olympic Games. Wonderful performance. People say that Chinese male athletes are not good at body contact events. Xiaobo said going into these Olympic Games, I'll try my best to change their views. Well, well done, Lou. You have done that. A bronze medal tells us all that, yes, you are a power athlete.